This is an example of a first order decay trend. Each order has its own equation for predicting how much reactant remains as a function of time. But we're only going to work with the first order decay equation for the short term right now. The objective here is an equation that will predict the amount of substance remaining as a function of time in a chemical process. I emphasize and underline remaining because that's exactly what this is illustrating. For example, if we have a point right here, go over and straight down, say this time, this is the remaining concentration right here. That is the stuff that has not decayed. So much of it has decayed. And some of the problems that you will face as you get into this is that the problem will start out a 40% of substance has decayed. How long does it take for 40% to decay? Well, the equation is not going to refer to how much decayed, but how much remains. So you'd have to take 100 minus the 40 and use that number. And you'll see how this comes up. I'm making a statement. It may not make sense now, but it will in a second. Now, out of this, the concept of rate generates what we call the integrated rate law. And it is a simple calculus derivation that is applied to the definition of rate of reaction. And it's a very classic, but what comes out of this is the first order decay equation, and you can derive one for each order, but we're only interested in the first order. And it turns out to be C final to equal C initial, what you begin with, E, which is the base to the natural log, K, rate constant, times whatever time is involved in the reaction. And this is a classic decay trend. It's called a first order decay equation, the first order decay trend. And it predicts this C final as a function of time. Well, one other equation that goes with this is half-life equation. Now, half-life in a first order decay trend is a constant. Let me come down here. Okay, when we talk about the concept of half-life, that is the calculation of a time needed for 1/2 of original amount concentration to decay. So if this is 100%, this would be 50%, or CO over 2, the initial amount divided by 2. That is half of the original amount, right? And if we go over here and it's dropped straight down to the axis right here, that's called the first half-life. Now, from that point to the end, we divide that in half again, say right here, that's where 25% of the original amount remains, and we track that over to the curve and then down here, that's the second half-life. And then we can go to 12.5% remaining, track that over to the curve and down, that'll be the third half-life. The half-life in each of these is a constant. For first order reactions, or first order decay. If this is applied to the half-life equation, I mean, to the decay equation, we can derive the half-life equation out of this, so that the final concentration will be CO over 2 equals CO e to the minus KT, and that simply can cancel out your concentration terms. You don't need them for a first order decay process. So that this leads to 1/2 equals e to the minus kt, and that becomes a half-life term. Well, again, I'm going to take reciprocal of both sides of the equation. Now I'll have 2 to equal e to the minus kt, then I'm going to take the logarithm of both sides of this. And the logarithm of e to the minus kt is a minus kt. The logarithm of 2 is 0.693. Memorize that. Minus k, well, taking the reciprocal of it changes that to positive. I'm sorry. Taking the reciprocal of this changes that to a positive. And that should be positive. That's positive. 1/2. So this, from this, we can get two things. Given the rate constant, we can calculate half-life, or given the half-life, we can calculate a rate constant. So I'm going to work two or three problems now, showing you how these two equations are used to predict outcomes of reactions. Let's write the two equations down just to... And then KT to the 1/2 is equal to 0.693. So these are very, very important in the problems you'll be seeing coming exam day, and are referred to as the classic first order decay. Okay, so we're going to use this to calculate the final concentration at 2 hours. Now, notice the K value is in seconds, so hours need to be in seconds. That's 3,600 seconds per hour. Then that's 7,200 seconds. Okay, so applying this data to the first order equation, C final is equal to the initial 0.0248 mole per liter, E to the minus, now bracket this and put the K value is 2.2 times 10 to the minus 5 reciprocal seconds, and that's going to cancel out with the time second. I see year and year. So I'm going to save space. I'm just going to put 7,200 bracket. So one of the things you need to do and when you get home, be sure you can handle this kind of setup and calculation in your fancy calculators. Now, what I suggest tell students is do what's in parentheses, the brackets first, and then apply a negative to the exponent. So to illustrate this, to the minus whatever number we get out of that, 2.2 times 10 to the minus 5 times 7,200.1584. Now notice the units have dropped out of it. So the only units we have is molarity. So that's what it should come out. Now, this portion of the calculation is what is called the reduction factor. Reduction or decay factor. Because this is going to come out as a fraction that you multiply times the original concentration to give you a smaller number, which is what's generally expected. So I punch in 0.1584, get a negative value, second, and this becomes now 0.0248 times the reduction factor will be 0.8535, everything comes out in molar terms. So 85% of the original concentration remains in our calculation here. So 0.0212 molar of the original concentration remains after 2 hours. Now the problem didn't ask you to calculate half-life, but with the K value given, here we can do that using the half-life equation. Half-life equals 0.693 over the K value. Punch that in and that tells you the time it takes for one half of the concentration here to divide into 0.124. How long does it take? So I guess we put that down here. Tell you the one half for this. 0.693 over the K value, 0.693 over 2.2 times 10 to the minus 5 reciprocal seconds. Seconds will be the the units of the final value. I get 31,500 seconds for the concentration to reduce to one half its original value. Well, how long does it take the second half life to decrease to 25% of the original value? The same amount. The first half life takes 3.1 times 10 to the 4 seconds. The second half-life, that is from 50% to 25%, is still the same number. Now, how long does it, the questions will come to you, how long does it take for 75% of this compound to decay? That means 25%. You have to add the two half-lives together. Looks like this. Okay, so this is 100%. That's what we started with this The original amount was 0.0248 molar. All right, and to drop to half of that, 1.28. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and a half. Right, looks like about a halfway point right there. Okay, that's your 10 to the 1/2 1, if you want. Well, that's 31,500 seconds. Okay, that's 50% remaining. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, about right in here, I guess. 25% remaining, or 75% decayed. If I know. There's your second half-life. Well, it also is 31,500 seconds. So the time in here is 31,500. This is 31,500. And if you go to the next one, okay, third half-life, that'll be 31,500 also. But to say 70, how long does it take for 75% to decay, add these two together. So that's what, 73,000. When you take that into consideration. Make sense? Okay. So for 75% to decay, it equals two half-lives. Two first half-lives, if you will. Or all of them the same. And that is 2 times 31,500 seconds. And that looks like 73,000 seconds. You divide it by 24 days, weeks, on then go wherever you want. But that's on certain questions on the exam. Now it wants to know what is the concentration final after 256 seconds. Well, you can't do that with just the given data directly. You have to determine the K value from the first order decay equation first. So if you look at this data and the first order decay equation, you have a C final, C initial, and a time.
Can
you turn the screen off? Yeah. Hang on, let me get it back up here. My bad. There we go. Okay, so compare the data given to the first order. Let me turn it on. I guess it's wrong. Oh, it cut itself off. I must have cut it off.